Transpose a data table in UiPath is needed in some cases. But what does transpose data table mean? And how to do that? There are different ways to do it in UiPath. Either using invoke code activity and writing a code in VB.NET or C#. Or also using custom activities, which you can import from UiPath Marketplace, like this one here. But we can also do the same using a very simple link query. In this video, I will show you how to transpose a data table using a link query. I will also show you how to convert the new table to a dictionary. I have other videos on my channel about transpose data table using a code, and also two videos about dictionary. If you want to learn more about that, you can check these videos. Let's now start learning that using a link query. Let's first understand, what does transpose a data table mean? Assume I have the following table, which contains three columns and one row. For some reasons we need to have the same table, but another structure. To do that we can use transpose data table for example. Transpose is to convert the table to another table, where the rows are converted to columns, and the columns are converted to rows. Or we can also convert the rows and columns to rows, but another format. For example, the following table should look like this table after transposing. As you see, I have now only two columns, name and value. The column name contains the columns of the old table. And column value contains the rows of the old table. We mostly use this structure to convert this new table later to dictionary, so that we can get the values from the table more easier, once we have it as dictionary. This is what transpose data table mean and what we are going to do in this video. Let's switch to UiPath to write the link query. I have here build data table activity, where I define the original table. It will be stored in this variable. Let's see the table. I have the same table, what I showed you before. It consists of three columns. And there is only one row. We mostly use transpose data table for tables, which have only one row and different columns. And here I have another build data table activity. This table is stored in this variable. Let's see this table. It consists of two columns, name and value. This is the table, where I want to store the transpose table later. And I define these two columns, which I want to have in the table later. We don't have any rows now, because the rows will be calculated later using the link query. I will add an assign activity to write the query. I will explain the query later. I have first a loop for the rows. Then I have a second loop for the columns. Here I used cast function. If you don't know how to use this function, please check the following video. I explain the function in detail there. After that I select the data I need in this way. I am adding the row to the new table. As you know, this table consists of two columns, name and value. This means that we need to add two values, one value for each column. For the first column I am adding the column name from the original table. And for the second column I am adding the content of this column. It means that I am adding the row content using the column name. At the end I have this function to convert the output to data table. Let me now explain you the query using the data we have. Here is the original table, and also the output table. We have first a loop for the rows. Each row will be stored in this variable, row. This means, at the first iteration the variable row has this row as value. After that I have the loop for the columns. Each column will be stored in this variable, col. In select statement we add the rows to the output table. Let's see it step by step. We have here first the variable col with the function column name. As you know, col variable has in the first iteration the value id as column. And using the function column name we get the value id as string. It means, we added id to the first column in the output table. After that, we have the following statement to add the value for the second column. Here I use two variables, row and col. Row has the first row as value, and col still have the ID column as value. Using row and column name, we get the content of the column from the current row. It means I will get this value as output from this expression. This will be added to the second column in the output table. At this point, the first iteration is done. Now we move on to the second iteration. In the second iteration, we still have the same row, but another column. It's the second column, item. We do the same here. So we add first the column name to the first column. And then the value from the row of this column into the second column in the output table. The second iteration is also done. In the third iteration, we also do the same. We first add the column name to the first column in the output table. Then we add the value from the row of this column into the second column in the output table. At this point, we looped all rows and columns, and there are no rows or columns more. Therefore, we move on to the last line in the query. Here it's only converting from enumerable to data table type. This is how the query works step by step. I will now add output data table activity to convert the table to string, to print it out in the console, so that you can check the result. I will add the output table here. And here I will create a string variable. I will add write line activity to print out the string table. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I have the table as output here. I have only two columns, name and value. And here I have the different data from the original table. In the first column we have the column names from the original table. And in the second column we have the data from the row of the original table. This is how to transpose a data table using link query. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, I will show you how to convert the transformed data table into a dictionary. Before I show you that, let's do a recap about dictionary data type, how is it structured and how to use. Dictionary is like any other data type, such as string, boolean, integer, etc. So it's a data type for a variable, where we can store data. The data in a dictionary variable looks like this one here. We have two parts, key and value. For example, this variable contains two keys. For each key there is a value. Normally we already know the key and want to get the value of this key. It means, for example, I already know that I have a key with the name URL. But I don't know which URL I have. To get the URL I have to use the key. To get the value I can use it in this way. Assume the dictionary variable has the name X. I mean X is a variable of type dictionary. To get the URL I'm going to use the variable X with the key URL in this way. As result for this expression I will get the following value. This is what dictionary means and how to use. If you are working in UiPath with dictionary, you should know dictionary. For more details about dictionary, please check the following two videos. So now you know what does dictionary mean in general and how to use. Let's now see how to convert a data table into a dictionary in UiPath using link query. I will first create a variable of type dictionary in this way. I am searching for dictionary. I will use this one. We have to select a data type for key and value. I will use string for both, but you can choose any data type you need for each one. It depends on your need, what you want to store in this variable. So I have now a dictionary of type string. And now I will add an assign activity to write the link query. I will write the query in method syntax, but I can also use mixed syntax. First I use the data table variable, which I want to convert to dictionary. For that I use the function as enumerable, to convert it to enumerable type, so that I can use enumerable methods. After that I use the function to dictionary. This function consists of two parts. Or in other words, for this function we need two input parameters. One for key and one for value. I added a lambda expression for each one. For the key I use the column name from the data table. This means that I want to set the content of column name as key in the dictionary. And for value I use the column value from the data table. This means also that I want to set the content of column value as value in the dictionary. This is how to convert the table to a dictionary. I have an error here, because I didn't define which type should be selected for key and value. So I will add to string function, to convert the content of both columns to string. This is only needed, because the dictionary type is string. But if I using object for example, I don't need to use to string function. Now I don't have any errors. I will add some write line activities to show you, how to use the dictionary to read data. I already know that I will have for example the key ID. So here I want to get the value of this ID. And the same for the key item. And also the same for the key price. Let's now execute the code to check the result. I have here first the table from the old query. And here you can see the new result. First I have the value of key ID. Then the value of key item. And the last one is the value for key price. This is how to convert a data table into a dictionary. I hope you enjoyed the video and could learn something new and useful today. Thanks for watching and have a great day.